Hi everybody and welcome to another video. My name is Torge Petersen from the Software PE Group at Danfoss Power Solutions, and in this video I will show different PoU cases and the available language types related to the IEC 61139-3 standard. C code and guide PoU is not part of this video, but is more described in the videos number 98 and 99. I created a project called CityLight to show you different use cases in this video regarding guide PoU. The code in this video based on the logic used from different PLC software development tools supplier and shows a small example for a traffic signal unit which is supposed to control two traffic signals at an intersection. I have programmed the logic fully in PLC code PoUs and used all five available IEC 61139-3 languages. Structure text, function block diagram, ladder logic diagram, sequential function chart, and instruction list. Using all five languages was not necessary, but I divided the code logic in all five languages to show you all different PoU use cases and how to use each language individually and to give maybe a starting point for your project. In guide, the logic is as simple as possible. It is embedded inside the standard template under application and the guide block PoU CityLight. The only guide code which is used is the call PoU component to call the main PoU PLC program. As I said, all logic has been programmed in PLC code. The only additional guide code in this example is under output, the checkpoints to make the signals visible via the service tool. Let's have a look to the PoUs and code structure. I use the standard PoU name PLC program, which is normally used in PLC development systems for the first and main PoU, but instead of the type program, which is not supported in guide, I use the type function block. For the PLC program PoU, I choose the language sequential function chart, which fits best for my example code. In addition, I added two more PoUs, one PoU called traffic with the type function block and the language function block diagram. In this PoU traffic, the individual traffic signal sections to the lights are assigned, which means to make sure that the red light is lit red in the red section and in the yellow-red section, the yellow light in the yellow and yellow-red section, the green light in the green section only, and no light in the off section. Via the input variable status, five different conditions for the traffic signal sections will be defined as green, yellow, yellow, red, red, and off. These sections are also declared as output signals and represents the colored traffic signal. The sections off represents a state when the max number of counts, so one count is a change from red to green, has been reached. It is a kind of night modus or something similar where all lights are off. The second PoU is called wait, also defined with the type function block, but with a language instruction list. In this PoU wait, a simple timer is programmed, which as input will receive the length of the section in milliseconds, and as output will produce true as soon as the time period is finished. I use the standard function block clock generator called TP. Inside the instruction list code editor, there might be a minor issue with the end of line interpretation. Instead of the known return comment, the last line needs to be empty in the guide PLC editor, just in case if the compiler will end up with an end of line error. The main PoU PLC program combines everything so that the right light lights up at the right time for the desired time period. I used two instances from the function block PoU traffic and also two of the type wait. The beginning diagram of a PoU in sequential function chart, shortly SFC, starts with an empty init step with the name start by default and a following transition. For my example CityLights, I added one step for each traffic signal section to determine the structure of the diagrams. Just drag the SFC element from the code block and drop it into the SFC code area. Same for the jump element. The first transition always switches through and all others switch through when the wait instance called delay produces a true signal, which means when the set time period is finished. Each individual step needs to be programmed via the so-called actions and transition conditions. These can be added or selected via the query command on a step element. New SFC actions needs to be added inside the code block. Right-click, select Add Action, and choose the SFC action language as well. At the bottom of the SFC code area, you have access to all actions and transitions in separated tabs. I added some actions written in structured text and ladder diagram to have all five IEC 61139-3 languages available in one project. We will have a closer look to each in the following. Starting inside PLC program, the main SFC. Each step provides an action and a transition. Inside the query dialog, you can select one or, if you want, add more action and select the available actions. You are not able to create a new action inside this query dialog. You can only select from the already added ones. Once again, inside the code block under main SFC and the subfolder action, you are able to add actions. There you can see also the transitions folder where you can add new transitions via right click. Back to the query dialog of SFC step. After you selected the action, you need to select the qualifiers, which describe how an action associated with a step is executed. Last but not least, you can select the transition expression, true as the standard transition, or you can select one of the added transitions. This needs to be done for each action. Let's have a look to each action itself and how it has been programmed. Action init written in structured text is used to initialize the variables and to set a start condition. I first call the function block traffic 1, where the status of the traffic signal 1 is set to 1, which is green. Second, I call the function block traffic 2, where the status of the traffic signal 2 is set to 3, which is red. In addition, I initialize the counter value to 0. In structured text, I recommend to use the auto code completion and hint function, which helps you to pick the right variable or function block which are listed dependent of your typed character. While this autocode completion, you can save time to pick up variables easily, check if the variable has been declared, and you can see the parameter's direction. Like in function blocks, for instance, you can easily check the parameter direction via the hint function. In guide setup, you can do some settings regarding the autocode completion trigger time and the hint delay time. Action switch 1 written in structured text changes the status of traffic signal 1 to 2, so from green to yellow, and that of traffic signal 2 to 4, from red to yellow red. In addition, a time delay of 2 seconds is now set, or 2000 milliseconds. Action count, it is also written in structured text and is used to increment the counter of switches. Transition stop is written in ladder diagram to have all five IEC 61139 languages implemented inside this project. This transition will provide a true signal if the counter is greater than the maximum limit. Action off, it is written in structured text, set the status of traffic signal 1 and 2 to 5, which means off. This action off will be processed if the counter has been reached a defined limit. See also the transition stop, and can be used, for example, as a kind of night mode where the lights are switched off. Action green 2, with this action also written in structured text, the traffic signal 2 is set to green, so status 1, and traffic signal 1 is set to red, which is status 3. This status is set with a time delay of also 2000 milliseconds. Action switch 2 has the same logic as switch 1, just with inverted status for traffic signal 1 and 2. Same for action green 1, which has the same logic as green 2, just with inverted status for traffic signal 1 and 2. All the needed traffic signal logic is located inside these three POUs. Or, as I already said at the beginning, there is not much coding needed in guide for this project. The only needed code is to call the PRU via the guide component callPRU. With the PRU provided output signals, I created some checkpoints which I used to create a service tool page. I use the MC24 controller, but you can use, of course, any other controller like a MC, SC, or a display, or even joystick. Anything which is +1 guide programmable. The easiest way to store or maybe share these PRU logic is via my code. Simply right-click on the PLC unit and select Add to my code. Now the PLC unit is stored under your my code location in a PLC OpenXML standard. This location can be subversion controlled, for example, or shared with other users or used in other projects. Instead of the PLC unit, you can of course store the guide page or block inside the My Code tab as a SCS file. Just go to File and select Export Block or Page and select the code block or page with the mouse. I downloaded the code on my MC24 controller and created a simple service tool page to make the traffic signal logic visible. I used the standard log components to show the Boolean signal and images, which with visibility settings to show and hide the light. This guide code and the service tool file are available via the update center. So if you want to take a look or a deeper look how it has been added to the guide code, or if you would like to test it on your own hardware. We hope that you found this tutorial useful. Remember that +1 community help is available on the +1 user forum. Check out other videos on our YouTube channel or contact the +1 help desk. Thank you for your attention.